ANC, NEC member defends Floyd Chivambo, EFF, and Julius Malema and say, listen, when what? Chifiwa Mutodzi. It was like, oh, when you are pulling this this stance, Sabo Angelo agrees. It's like, ay, nyakbona when I nyakbona. But for me, is the fact that they are being defended by who? A whole Lungisa, a member of the ANC, NEC member, right? Coming out and saying, nah. This, there's something wrong. And you know why I will agree with this person? It's because for the fact that now we are being directed to, or the VPS is being made an EFF thing, we've got Palapala who has a case singular directed to Palapala. Now they are busy taking the VPS, making it an EFF. I'm not saying if they've taken something there, they are not guilty of it. But it's not their thing. There are many people who were there. Why EFF alone? Today, when you think of VPS, you're going to be thinking of EFF. That's my problem. It can't be that there were 100 people who were participated in that. But today you want to make it an EFF thing. Guy, something is not make sure there. Be careful of media and be careful of media and the propaganda. Here is propaganda 101. Telling you, here is propaganda 101. Why and how is it that we don't get to know about all the other names? How is it that the media doesn't push all the other names? They are busy with the one of EFF. Aye. Konok Shayaman's lab. Yan chela njalun. Kaplani mid. Not mina nga. Not mina bafana magita ngin chela. Yan chela njal. Kaplani mid. Media is very dangerous, guys. But yes, dangerous as media may be, it is also dangerous that people, you know, you ask them that to need to subscribe, they don't. You need to, you know, you ask them to borrow you their cars, they don't. Their house, they don't. Their children, they don't. You know, it would be worse if I ask you to borrow you. Look, if I ask you to borrow me your wife, you'd be like, oh, bongan, hey, wakwakbuna, bloko, no chumbolo, ngoskazu, amgazu, mshanyela wen. You know, then again, just imagine. Gota gatshile lap, eh? Gatshile lap. But again, after that, then I ask you to do just something simple. And I say to you, can you just do this?
If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 Rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, so let's go on. Lungisa, escorted by EIOL. Lungisa has got this to say. The article from EIOL was written by Sipho Jack, published this July 2024, obviously. ANC National Executive Committee, NEC member, Andile Lungisa, has characterized the allegation against EFF deputy leader Floyd Chivambo as nothing but a witch hunt. Maybe you don't understand what he's saying. Don't worry, I'm here for that. He says, Lungisa says, this was a classical statement of degradation to black young men. He says, VPS chairperson Chifiwa Matonzi is a new version of Angelo Agrees, who won't allow any attack against Africans from a colonial secular media based. Now I've got a problem with media, guys. How they report about this VPS thing, guys? Something is not make sure, guys. But let's continue. Lungisa says there was nothing that attached Chivambo to the VPS saga. Oh! Oh, akusiyim, guys, akusiyim. Mina ngiphatha nganono la. Ulungisa. Uphethe nganono. Pa, pa, to the media. Oh, okay. Asidlule lapho ngaze nikhale. Siqhubekene. Bathike. If you read the affidavit, nothing seriously implicate Floyd Chivambo or anybody else. A person who embarked on an expedition of consulting individual, it was the chair of VPS who became a new version of Angelo Agrees. Well, I don't have time, guys. If I had all the time in the world, I would have easily reminded you good to who Angelo Agrees is. But yeah, now yabona lento le, guys. I don't know how can I say this, but you know, sometimes I love people who stands for something in life. People who are flip-floppers. I'm not saying Lungisa is. I'm not saying that. I'm saying that Abo Angelo agrees, right? When their things catch up with them, now they want to bring everybody into it. No, you are a man. Stand for your thing, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, come on. He said that it was an old agenda used by politicians to permanently implicate Africans for things which they had not standing in a court of law, right? They had no standing in a court of law. The former Youth League deputy president said the agenda was to dent their image in the court of public opinion, led by what he called the secular neo-colonial media. Hey, Lungisa, the way you blame them. Hey, my friend, I wouldn't have said it better. I'm sure they thought I was going to defend them. I ain't. Yeah, guys, the way I can tell you this, when you read an article coming from Daily Maverick, when you read an article coming from News 24, you always know that article is either attacking Jacob Zuma and all of those people, or people who are against Ramaphosa, even in the ANC, or just promoting Ramaphosa and the DA. It's just two things on politics. It does those two things very well, right? So why would you trust such people? I wouldn't trust them either. That's media for you. It's very filthy. Very, very filthy, very dangerous at the same time. In manipulating people, making people think that they are an advocate of the truth. What? Truth of what? Let's continue. The company was provided to me by Floyd Chivambo to make payment that I promised to the EFF. I made this promise following a new news which had broken to the media that VPS had granted former President Jacob Zuma a home loan for his Nkondla resident, Nkondla. Negative public scrutiny and blah, blah, blah from EFF. So, in other words, you are saying I decided to bribe them. I'm going to throw a spinner into this one. If you have followed the case of Senzo Meyiwa, right? There's a character they called, there's a lead investigator they called Brigadier Bongani Kininda. He was involved in a certain case of a guy called, but the name is almost similar to that. So when they were arresting, when they wanted to get this guy, ne, this guy, Senzo Meyiwa case, who's in charge of docket 375, Makubu, yes. When they wanted to charge Makubu, what they did, they went to that guy who was already arrested and asked him to make a statement. I'm saying something that is already out there in the media. So they went to the guy, they asked the guy to make a statement to implicate Makubu so that they can arrest Makubu. So he made a statement. Later on, he realized that they didn't even keep up his promise and then he turned against them. That tells me, it sets precedence that it is possible that these people can get somebody who's already implicated to say, or even those, by the way, they did that with somebody where they found a complaint against Defo. They found people to complain against him. If you're looking at some of these complaints, they were like, this doesn't make sense. This one doesn't make sense. But that's what they did. So I'm saying to say, it is possible in this case that they just found, they just pushed the guy or forced the guy to implicate these ones. So he implicated them. It's also possible, not that that's what happened.